Hi everyone, welcome back to Learning Power BI and Accessible Design. I am Juliana Smith, and in today's tutorial, I'll show you how to build an S-curve in Power BI. From my experience reporting on project controls, I know that S-curves are a common request. They are essential for tracking project performance by comparing planned progress against actual progress over time. If you have not yet checked out my two-part article series on this topic, I highly recommend you reading them first. I will put the link in the video description. So in those articles, I cover key concepts like setting up the data model, adding a date dimension table, managing multiple data columns, and using the function useRelationship to handle inactive relationships. So on this video, I will only focus on building the S-curve itself. So first, let's look into the DAGs used. For the S-curve, we need cumulative totals. So I have created a measure to calculate the cumulative total for the forecast start. So all the activities that are forecast to start. And then also the cumulative count of the activities that have actually started. So first I have my forecast start. So it uses the function calculate to modify the context of evaluation, focusing on the measure that I created before, which is the count of activities based on the forecast date. And then I have the cumulative count of activities that based on the actual start date. So I am calculating this cumulative sum, but only up to the reporting date, which is the cutoff date for this specific report. This is important because it will prevent our S-curve to have the actual started line extending beyond as a flat line. So I'll show you shortly what that means. And again, on these DAGs, it uses the F function to first check if the maximum date is the current context, which is our reporting date. And if it is, it will, the measure will calculate the cumulative totals using the function calculate and filter. Again, if you check my articles, I explain step by step what the measure is doing. So now to build our S-curves is very simple. We just need a line chart. And for my X-axis, I am going to use my date. And for my Y-axis, I'm going to use my cumulative count of my, based on my forecast start date. And then the cumulative count based on the actual starter date. So you can see here that it already has the S curve shape that is expected. You can see here that my actual start, so my line that's got the cumulative count of the actual started, it stops at my cutoff point. And I will show you now what would happen if you don't use a cutoff point. So I'm going to remove it here. And I already created that. So you can see here the line. This is our cutoff point, but it extends as a flat line because nothing else is happening after that. So I'm going to remove it and put back the line that I want. And then something else that you can do to actually show what is your cutoff point. When you go on the format pane on these further analysis to your visual, so if you just click there, you can add an x-axis constant line. So I'm going to add my line. And you can add a date manually, but I created a measure for that. So I'm going to go on the field and I'm going to get my measure that's got the reported date. So you will add a line with the report that it shows the cutoff point. And you can also add the date, the label for that. The label for that can be the data value or the name, which we don't want that. So I can just put here. Report cutoff date. And you can also have both. I was going to say that it's a report cutoff date, and it will also say what is the date. So now that we have our S-curve, we need to format it because we don't want to give these visual to our clients. And I'm going to show you how to format these S-curves so it's also accessible. So the first thing that we have to consider in terms of accessibility is font size. We don't want to have really small font size. So ideally, we should have a font size above 12 points. So I'm going now to back to my visual here. I'm going to format my axes. First, my x-axis, I want my values to be, 9 is way too small. So I'm going to put it to 13. I'm going to change the color to black. And then my title, my axe title, do not remove the title, just leave it. And also, I'm just going to make it bold here. It's already 12 points. I'm not going to change it. And then if we go to the y-axis, we need to do the same thing. I'll put it to 13. And then in title, I don't want this auto title. I'm gonna give a better name. So I'm just gonna call it cumulative count of activities. Right, so we have now our axis formatted. Let's now go to our title. I want to give a meaningful title. So I'm gonna call it project tracking, and it is forecast. Gonna call it start date. Forecast start date versus actual start date. Gonna make it a bit bigger. To 20 so we can see a bit better. Now I need to format my legend as well. So if I go back to the visual legend text, so let's make sure that it's big enough. I'm gonna make it big. There we go. 13. I want to use black as well, and I don't want it to have those names. So I'm gonna have to go here on my where I put my measures. I'm gonna rename it. So I'm going to put one. Okay. The first one is forecast start, and the other one, actual start. Actually started. There we go. So it's already looking a little bit better. And for my legend, I also want to give title, and my title will be series. And you can put all centered. Let's also put the title centered. There we go. So now we have formatted our title, our axis. We need now to take something else into consideration. So in terms of accessibility, we should not only use colors to convey information. So rely only on the different colors to differentiate the forecast start and the actual start. It's not great. For line charts, there are different ways you can add additional information to help our users identify what is what. I'm going to show you three of them. So the first one, if I go to my visual again on the lines, so I'm going to select my forecast start. Something that we can do, we can change the line style. So instead of having us two solid lines, I'm going to keep my actual line solid, but I'm going to make my forecast one dashed. So you can see that they are different. Another way to help our users to differentiate these two series is by adding different markers. So if I go on the markers and my forecast start, I'm going to switch it on. I'm just going to put a bit smaller. There we go. I have the circle for my forecast start. For my actual start shape, I'm going to put my triangle. There we go. But then if we do that, of course, you have to go to our legend and change the style. So if you add different markers, you add line and markers. If you add different line styles, I would say just go add the line so it will show if it's dashed or solid. And another way to do that, so I'm going to switch off my markers. Another way of doing that is adding the series label. So if you enable it, it will name each one of the series directly on the chart. But if you do that, we can just increase a little bit. Just making sure that it is above 12 points of font size. But that is another way. So what I like doing when I'm working with S-curves is changing the line style. So I usually keep one of them solid and the other one dashed. And then here, my legends will show that which one is dashed and which one is a solid line, helping our users to identify what is what. We have the report cutoff date. We can also try to change that. So I'm going to put a different color. I'm going to put it dotted. There we go. And my data label, I'm going to change color as well. There we go. So now talking about colors. So whenever we create any visualization or any text on our screen, we should consider the color contrast. So whenever we have a text sitting on a background, the color contrast between the text and the background should be of at least 4.5 to 1. There are tools available online that you can check your color contrast. I'll put the link of them on the video description as well. And it's not only that, we also have to make sure that there is enough contrast between non-text elements and the background. So for example, the lines that we have on the line chart, we have to make sure that the colors we choose have at least 3 to 1 in terms of color contrast against the background. So that means if you have a really light background like I have here, my text should be a bit darker and my line color should also be a bit darker. And there is something else as well that we need to consider in terms of accessibility, which is alternative text. Power BI allows us to add alternative text for all non-text elements. And that is very important, especially for those who need screen readers. So if to do that, we go on the general, and then there is the box to enter the alt text. These has to be concise and explain what it is in a simple way. And there is a limit of 250 characters that we can add as alt text. So this is my, I created one, I'm going to just paste here, which is line chart displaying cumulative count of forecast versus actual started activities for a screen reader friendly format, view the data table or press alt shift F11. So I don't know if you know that Power BI has this built-in accessibility feature. So if you click on the three dots and show us table, so whatever visual that you have, it will also show the data in a tabular format, which is compatible with screen readers. So that's it for today. Thanks a lot for watching this video. You now can build your own accessible S-curve. Let me know how you go, and goodbye.